Hello guys, this is Indian Medico, and in this video we are going to see about MEN1 syndrome. This is a concise presentation for medical students. First let us see about multiple endocrine neoplasia syndromes, that is MEN syndromes. These are a group of familial disorders characterized by development of neoplasms in multiple endocrine glands. These neoplasms are derived from APUD cells, that is amine precursor uptake decarboxylation cells. These neoplasms may develop synchronously or metachronously. MEN syndromes are inherited in an autosomal dominant fashion with 100% penetrance but variable expressivity. Now let us see about the various MEN syndromes. MEN1 syndrome is also known as Wermer syndrome. The components are parathyroid hyperplasia, pancreatic islet tumors, and pituitary tumors. MEN2A syndrome is also known as Sippel syndrome, and the various components are medullary thyroid carcinoma, pheochromocytoma, and parathyroid hyperplasia. MEN2B syndrome includes medullary thyroid carcinoma, pheochromocytoma, mucosal neuromas, and marfanoid habitus. Now let us see about MEN1 syndrome in detail. As discussed earlier, it is also known as Wermer syndrome. It is caused by a defect in chromosome 11 and it involves a tumor suppressor gene. The common components of MEN1 syndrome are primary hyperparathyroidism, pancreatic islet cell tumors, and pituitary tumors. Now let us see about the clinical features of MEN1 syndrome. Most patients present with pancreatic hypersecretion. The most common tumors include gastrinomas and insulinomas. So there will be symptoms of peptic ulcer disease or hypoglycemia. The neoplasms are usually malignant, multicentric, and microadenomas. Hyperparathyroidism presents similarly to sporadic hyperparathyroidism with hypercalcemia. The pituitary neoplasm is associated with headaches, visual field defects, galactorrhea and amenorrhea in women, and hypogonadism in males. The neoplasms are usually prolactinomas. Now let us see about the management of MEN1 syndrome. Biochemical confirmation of hypersecretory states should be done. If hypercalcemia is present, total parathyroidectomy with autotransplantation should be done. Resection of pancreatic tumors depends on the type of tumor present. For pituitary prolactinomas, bromocriptine or capergolin or pergolate should be given to decrease the size and inhibit hormone production of prolactinomas. It should be followed by surgical ablation or irradiation or both. There are certain differences between neoplastic disorders in familial, that is MEN forms and sporadic forms. These include gastrinomas are usually malignant with MEN1 but they are benign with sporadic forms. Insulinomas are multiple with MEN1 but generally solitary with sporadic forms. If you have any suggestions, please let me know in the comment section. For more such videos, please check out my playlists. If you like my videos, kindly subscribe. Your subscription will encourage me to make more videos. Thank you.